गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग। सो एज यूजुअल वी आर द फर्स्ट टू जॉइन द
ऑलवेज
ऑलवेज। आप लोगों ने तो योगा किया, देखा उसपे। हमारे से तो होता ही नहीं है, टांगे नहीं सीधी होती तो कभी कुछ पॉसिबल ही नहीं है। और वेंकटेश क्रिकेट भी खेला संडे को कल?
नहीं सर, सुबह सुबह संडे देखो।
इसमें होस्ट कौन है? सर को होस्ट कर देना। कौन है होस्ट? अच्छा, माइक ऑफ है, माइक ऑफ।
अभिषेक।
अच्छा अभिषेक।
गुड मॉर्निंग डॉक्टर साहब, आवाज आ रही है?
जय जय कृषि
आ रही सर।
अरे मैसेज ऐसा सर के Good morning, everyone. Let's start the program by our tradition. Sir, shall we start, sir?
Yeah.
Let's start the program by our tradition. I request Abhishek to play ICR song. Abhishek, please.
जय जय कृषि परिषद भारत की, सुखद प्रतीक हरित भारत की। कृषि धन पशुधन मानव जीवन, दुग्ध मत्स्य फल यंत्र सुवर्धन। वैज्ञानिक विधि नव तकनीके, पारिस्थितिकी का संरक्षण। शस्य श्यामला छवि भारत की, जय जय कृषि परिषद भारत की। हिम प्रदेश से सागर तट तक, मरुधरती से पूर्वोत्तर तक। हर पथ पर है मित्र कृषक की, शिक्षा शोध प्रसार सकल तक। आशा स्वावलंबित भारत की, जय जय कृषि परिषद भारत की। जय जय कृषि परिषद भारत की।
थैंक यू रेस्पेक्टेड डायरेक्टर सर, ऑल द साइंटिस्ट कोलीग्स एंड स्टाफ ऑफ ICR कॉफी। I welcome you all for this today's program of celebration of International Yoga Day 2021 at our institute. Despite the fact that we all well aware of benefits of yoga and its importance in daily life, we must celebrate this important day just to create awareness and to inspire and motivate our dear and near ones. With this view, let me give a brief background of this International Yoga Day initiation. The idea of International Day of Yoga was first proposed by our current Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi, during his speech at United Nations General Assembly on 27 September 2014. When he proposed, he stated that yoga is an invaluable gift of India's ancient tradition. It embodies unity of mind and body, thought and action, restraint and fulfillment, harmony between nature and man, a holistic approach to health and well-being. It is not about exercise, but to discover the sense of oneness with yourself and the world and nature. By changing our lifestyle and creating consciousness, it can help in well-being. Let us work towards adopting an International Yoga Day. He stated this way, and when he stated later in 11th December 2014, they proposed the draft text, and that received broad support from 177 member states who sponsored the text, which was later adopted without a vote. This initiative found support from many global leaders. A total of 177 nations co-sponsored the resolution, which is the highest number of co-sponsors for ever any UNGS resolution of such nature. And also, when he proposed 21st June as a date, he also said that it is the longest day of the year in the northern hemisphere, and also it is the shortest day in southern hemisphere. And if you see from yoga perspective, the first yogi, also known as Adi Yogi, Lord Shiva, is said to have begun imparting the knowledge of yoga to the rest of mankind on this day. And that's why he became the first guru, that is Adi Guru. And since then, 2015, the first International Day of Yoga was observed around the world on 21st June 2015. The Ministry of Ayush has made the necessary arrangements in India since then. Through Pan India and abroad also, we are celebrating since 2015, and this is the 7th International Yoga Day. With this brief background, with kind permission from our director, sir, let me show the message from Sri Sri Ravi Shankar Gurudev, who is the founder of Art of Living Foundation and also a well-renowned personality in yoga.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Abhishek, please play the message.
जब आज पूरी दुनिया एक संकट की घड़ी से गुजर रही है, योग मानव जाति के लिए एक वरदान साबित हुआ है। योग से रोग का निदान, समस्याओं का समाधान, आत्मबल की वृद्धि होता हुआ हम देख रहे हैं। मन प्रफुल्लित रहती है, बुद्धि तीक्ष्ण हो जाता है। किसको नहीं करना है योग? सबको करना है, मगर कभी आलस्य हमको पकड़ लेता है, कभी हम समय का बहाना लेकर के कह देते हैं कि अरे हमारे पास समय नहीं है। जितना भी समय आप दे सकते हैं उतना ही लाभ आपको मिलेगा, इसलिए अवश्य योग करें, प्राणायाम करें, थोड़ी देर बैठ के ध्यान करें। ध्यान और प्राणायाम के बगैर सिर्फ योग व्यायाम बन के रह जाता है। यम नियम आसन प्राणायाम प्रत्याहार धारणा ध्यान समाधि, जब ये आठों अंगों को हम जीवन में उतारते हैं, जीवन में एक मूलभूत परिवर्तन हमको नजर आता है। वो क्या? कमजोरी से, बलहीनता से बल के ओर, दुख से प्रसन्नता के ओर, निरोगता के ओर हम चल पड़ते हैं। चलिए सबको प्रेरणा दीजिए, एक एक व्यक्ति योग करे। ऐसा नहीं इस करने के लिए विशेष सिद्धांतों को आपको मानना है। आप किसी भी मत संप्रदाय के अनुयायी हो कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता, मगर योग आपके लिए वरदान साबित होगी। जब हम संकट की घड़ी से गुजरते हैं सकारात्मकता की आवश्यकता है, और वो सकारात्मकता से ही बल मिलता है, और सकारात्मकता हमें प्राप्त होगी योग करने से, ध्यान करने से, प्राणायाम करने से। जब पूरी दुनिया आज एक संकट की घड़ी से गुजर रही है, योग मानव जाति के लिए एक वरदान साबित हुआ है, दुनिया के लिए भारत का अनमोल देन साबित हुआ है। हमारे देश में आबाल वृद्ध पर्यंत सभी लोग योग करना आवश्यक है। योग करने से हम न केवल अपनी सकारात्मकता को बढ़ाते हैं, मगर हम चारों ओर एक ऐसा सकारात्मक वातावरण निर्माण करने में सफल हो जाएंगे। आज ये बहुत आवश्यक है। जब लोग पीड़ा से, दर्द से, दुख से गुजर रहे होते हैं, उनके भीतर आत्मविश्वास, हिम्मत जगाना आवश्यक है। योग से ये अवश्य संभव हुआ है। इसलिए जहां कहीं भी कोई नकारात्मक मानसिकता से गुजर रहे हो, उनको बोलिए बैठ को योग करो, और जो सकारात्मक है, उत्साही है, उनको भी योग करना चाहिए ताकि वो उस उत्साह को बनाए रख सके। चलिए इस साल हम योग दिवस ऐसा मनाते हैं, अपने परिवार के साथ, अपने में, और सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग आदि सभी कानून को पालन करते हुए जीवन को एक उत्सव मनाते हैं।
थैंक यू फॉर योर पेशेंट लिसनिंग। दिस ईयर द International Yoga Day theme is Yoga for Well-being, Wellness. That is for both mental and physical wellness. And now in COVID era, it is very important, and better we should follow the words of Sri Sri Ravi Shankar Guruji. And we have prepared a poster to display in our sports complex permanently to stress upon the practice of yoga and its benefits. I request our director, sir, to kindly raise the curtain to reveal the poster for all of us.
Is it visible?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So this is why we should practice yoga. Yeah, please.
Now I request our director, sir, to kindly address the gathering.
Sir, yeah, thank you. Good morning to everyone. Today we began by accepting, adapting, practicing, and performing through yoga. This is not new to this country, but it became a new science to educate the entire universe, the developed, developing, and underdeveloped countries to unanimously accept yoga as the only basic pathway for peace and harmony. And this, we should be proud that this is one stress buster that we have given to this entire world, and also earmarked the 21st June based on the fundamentals that we believe in as the origin of Adi Guru. Now, this we must do every day. That's what the prescription is. But it is not necessary that everybody is performing in a manner which is prescribed here in the form of several asanas. It may be one or two also. Or it may simply be a process of meditation too, which is also part of the yoga proceedings. The basic thing is we want harmony. Harmony in what? In our physical and mental activities. And so we are able to bring in harmony with each other. This is the goal. So it's more a physical practice to gain mental stimulus to be healthy. And that is how the Ministry of Ayush also rightly said that yoga is the only hope which can bring strength and courage to every individual who practices it in a form where he or she is getting comfort. Now, we are all living in a world which we believe it is stressful today because of this pandemic situation also. It has brought in so much of stress to all of us. And we are not able to perform the way we are all supposed to be. And so we should begin this day as a healthy yoga day for all of us, because it gives more benefits, keeps you healthy, keeps you strong, keeps you also immune. So for example, here are a few points which befits our kind of ecosystem where we work. Working for long hours on your desk could not only hurt your spine but also make you feel tired at the end of the day. So practicing yoga asanas could help you improving your posture and also prevent in your stressful a lower back. So it also increases the body flexibility, as people say, because it has so much of postures to enable the performance. It builds your muscle strength in the process as we do this kind of physical asanas, and therefore boost also the metabolism to keep you healthy. It keeps your blood sugar lower because it increases the circulatory system and improves the body sensitivity. Keeps you away from diseases also, because the immunity is also boosted because your work, this yoga is giving you strength, both mental and physical. And it improves your lung function, which is quite important these days. We need more oxygen. That means the lungs have to function in a manner which it is desired to be. And at the end of the day, it allows you to sleep better and peaceful. By doing all these things, by one practice, that is asanas, which is prescribed in the yoga practice, you are going to get all these 9 benefits to keep the 10th benefit, which is because you will be happy, you will be harmonious, you are immune, your body is functioning properly, mentally you are stress-free. So all those things will add to your self-esteem finally. Final call is that you are going to get increased self-esteem, by which we are all will be able to have positive approach in our life and also of our dependents, colleagues, friends, and many others in the society. So we need to be very safe. We need to adapt at least 1 or 2 practices of yoga asanas and make it part of our life, and particularly educate the children, who will benefit much more than what we all would, which will bring in a very harmonious, peaceful country with very high esteem and so prosperity either. So we all will observe this day with all humility and sensitivity and throw the message of yoga for the benefit of many others through communications, messages of awareness, and any other modules that we feel appropriate. So with this, I wish all of you a very happy and healthy yoga day, and all of you stay safe. Thank you.
Thank you so much for your kind words, sir. As sir has rightly mentioned, for Indians, especially yoga is a not new thing. Since pre-Vedic period, India knows yoga, and also the early literature of yoga exists since 9th and 11th century itself. And also sir has mentioned, we need not to do all the type of complex asanas. Everyone can practice differently. Ministry of Ayush has given common yoga protocols and also separate videos for each age category. You can kindly check that website, and whichever is appropriate, you can practice from there. And now the program has come to end. It is a very short program. Thank you so much for all of your participation. Now I request Mr. Venkatesh to propose formal vote of thanks. Thank you.
Thank you, Asha. इट्स माय प्लेजर टू गिव वोट ऑफ थैंक्स ऑन दिस इंटरनेशनल योगा डे. रेस्पेक्टेड डायरेक्टर सर एंड ऑल द स्टाफ मेंबर्स ऑफ आईसीआर काफ्री, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू मेंशन मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ आयुष, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया फॉर टेकिंग लीड एंड arranging program in Pan India to celebrate this International Day of Yoga, and also grateful to ICR for initiating and promoting celebration of International Yoga Day in all ICR institutions in India. And I would like to convey my sincere thanks to our director sir, Dr. A. Arunachalam, ICR Kaffrey, for his guidance and support to conduct this program. And also we are grateful to the all staff members and their families for their active participation to make this program very successful. And once again, thank you very much. Do practice yoga, stay healthy, stay happy. Ultimately, health is wealth. And Jai Hind, Namaskar. Thank you.
Thank you all. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.